Simple pendulum. A simple pendulum consists of a heavy point mass. This is a point mass, heavy point mass, suspended from a rigid support. This is a rigid support by means of some elastic inextensible string. So the time period of this simple pendulum is given by t equal to 2 pi under root L by g. L is the effective length and g is the acceleration due to gravity. This is simple pendulum. So if this effective length L of simple pendulum is very, very large as compared to say x comparable to radius of earth, then the time period will be given by t equal to 2 pi and this expression, you know, you are adding L with the r. This r is the radius of the earth. And for a simple pendulum of say infinite length, if length is quite heavy than r, then you can just, you know, ignore L and just write this r. So this will be t equal to 2 pi under root r by g, which is 84.6 minutes. And if we have length which is equal to r, simple pendulum of length which is equal to the radius of earth, it gives you t equal to 2 pi under root r by g, which is 60 minutes. If the bob of the simple pendulum is suspended by say some metallic wire in this case, say of length L, and this length is having some coefficient of linear expansion, then because of the increase in temperature say by d theta, the effective length will change, and this is given by this expression, and the percentage increase in the time period will also be given by this expression. When a bob of simple pendulum of say density rho, it oscillates in a fluid of density rho 0, where this rho 0 is less than rho, then the time period will get increased, and the increased time period t dash will be given by this expression, t dash equal to t under root rho by rho minus rho 0. And when simple pendulum is in a horizontally accelerated vehicle, time period will be t equal to 2 pi under root 1 by under root a square plus e square. A is the horizontal acceleration of the vehicle. And when the simple pendulum is in vehicle which is sliding down an inclined plane like this, then its time period will be t equal to 2 pi under root L g cos theta. We have taken the cos component of the gravity value. So this theta is the angle of this angle, which is inclination of the plane. Seconds pendulum, a simple pendulum which is having a period of 2 seconds is called the seconds pendulum. So the effective length of second pendulum is this number of approximately 1 meter on earth. Conical pendulum. Now this conical pendulum, here the object will move like this in this manner. So if a simple pendulum is fixed at one end and the bob is rotating in a horizontal circle, so it is moving like this. In this case, it is called as a conical pendulum because it is eventually making a cone here. So in equilibrium, this t sin theta will be mr. This is again an omega sine, omega square. And time period is given by 2 pi under root mr by t sin theta. This is t tension. Tension has component t cos theta, t sin theta. This is theta angle. This is mr omega square. This is mg. So t cos theta will be equal to mg and t sin theta will be mr omega square. And this is how this has come. These values has come. Compound pendulum. Any rigid body mounted so that it is capable of swinging in a vertical plane. Now, if this is a horizontal plane, this body is moving in a vertical plane about say some axis which is passing through it in like inside this page. This is called a physical or a compound pendulum. And the time period here is given by this expression. This here the I, because one is L, one is I, the L is the distance of center of gravity from the center of suspension, but I is the moment of inertia of the body about an axis which is passing through the center of the suspension, and m is of course the mass of the body. Torsional pendulum. The time period of torsional pendulum, because some value is being given, and here there is some restoring force, or you can say restoring couple is acting. So we have a time period which is t equal to 2 pi under root I by c. This I is the moment of inertia body about the axis of rotation, and C is the restoring couple per unit twist. Restoring couple per unit twist. That is why this is called as a torsional pendulum, T equal to 2 pi under root I by C. Physical pendulum, when we have a rigid body of say any shape, this is also capable of oscillating say about any axis, right? It may pass or it may not pass through it. This is calling to be a physical pendulum. This is called as a physical pendulum. So here we have T equal to 2 pi under root I by N g d, and the symbols have their usual meaning. And in this case, we have this, say at this point, this is a proper body of any shape. So this simple pendulum whose time period is same as that of this physical pendulum is termed as a equivalent simple pendulum. You can write it as T equal to 2 pi under root I by M g d, which is equal to 2 pi under root L by g. The length of the simple pendulum, which is equivalent, is given by I equal to MD. Spring pendulum. So we have a point mass which is suspended from say a massless or light spring, which constitute a spring pendulum. So if the mass is now once pulled downwards here, so there is a stretch in this spring, and then it is released. So the system oscillated up and down. It goes like this, up and down. About its mean position, say this is the mean position. Simple, this is showing a simple harmonic motion. So the time period and frequency is given like this, T equal to 2 pi under root m by k. And of course, the frequency will be, this is nu or f, is given by 1 by 2 pi under root k by m. And if the spring is not light, but the spring also has some mass, say ms is the mass of the spring. Now this period of oscillation will become 2 pi under root m plus ms by 3 by k. This is the expression, which is m plus ms will be there. Oscillation of liquid in a U-tube. So if a U-tube is there like this, so there will be oscillation in the liquid. So if a liquid is filled up to say some height h in both the limbs of a U-tube, and now liquid is depressed up to say some small distance y in one limb and then release. So this liquid will show a movement like this. It will go up, go down, and the liquid column in U-tube will start doing or executing simple harmonic motion. So the time period of oscillation will be given by T equal to 2 pi under root h by g. The oscillation of a floating cylinder in liquid is given by T equal to 2 pi under root L by g. And this L is the length of the cylinder which is submerged in liquid in equilibrium.